How will you be 100 years from today? And I remember the great Sudanese poet Alpha Ituri writing about Africa. He says, "Oh, Mother Africa, how are you? Will you be great? You, Mother Africa, where your rebels have gained power and rebuilt, and they have destroyed what they rebuilt. Mother Africa, will you be great? You, Mother Africa," Faituri asks, "you, the home of great rivers, will your sons ever fish in your rivers?" Faituri asks, "You, Mother Africa, whose belly is laden with all things known as natural resources, will you ever give meaning to them?" Faituri asks, "Oh, Mother Africa, are you waiting for Godot, Mother Africa?" I believe that Africa can be made great again. But remember, I said that Africa took the view that she could grow regionally. That is where I went on a tangent. Now I come back. So the East African community was there, South African development community was there, we had COMESA, we had IGAD, we have ECOWAS, we had Central African Organization, we had the Maghreb, we had the Sahelians. All these attempts have been made, and somehow Africa is still punching below her weight. Let us look at the different sectors so that we are better able to appreciate what Africa can be. And I believe that Africa can be great. I believe that Africa is capable of looking at our agriculture, because if a people cannot feed themselves, they cannot be at the dinner table of civilization. Today, Africa cannot feed herself. Here in Ghana, they love rice. They produce a little and import most. Here in Ghana, they love ketchup, but I suspect they import some. Here in Ghana, they love chicken. They produce some, but I suspect they import some. In Nigeria, I suspect they love meat, and I suspect they import some. They love rice. Here in Ghana, I know they produce cocoa and they love chocolate, but the chocolate they make, they don't like very much. They import chocolate from Switzerland. So until the day that we begin to like what we produce, so that we add value, I look forward to the day when the greatest chocolate making factories will be here in Ghana. And the next will be in Togo, and the next in Cote d'Ivoire. It can be done. Which calls into question what our universities of agriculture doing. Are they involved? Are they included in the agenda of making Africa gain? And I'm saying that history has demonstrated that when people decide to work in agriculture, they can actually do something about it. I remember so very vividly in your own Malawi, when President Mbingu wa Mutharika took power, he took the view that he could improve agriculture in Malawi. He took the view that he could produce enough maize. He took the view that Malawians could do it. And you will agree with me, they did it. It was done in Malawi. Why can it not be done now? I remember so very vividly, those of you who are from Burkina Faso, in 1983, when Thomas Sankara took power, he took the view that the Burkinabe could feed themselves, and within 5 years, Burkina Faso could feed herself. It can be done. I know that right now, I remember so very vividly in Zimbabwe when President Mugabe took power, and even before then, during the first 5 years, Mugabe's government was capable of producing enough maize to be consumed in Zimbabwe and enough cotton to make clothes today, as I speak to you now, the Zimbabweans are under threat of starvation. What happened? It can't be done in Zimbabwe, and I believe that it must be done if Africa is to work. Africa can work in agriculture. Africa can work in innovation. I'm very glad that in the last 1 year, in Makerere, Uganda, they have come up with a solar-powered bus. Ugandans can do it. I'm very glad that in Nigeria, only last week, they unveiled a car that is made out of hydrocarbons. Nigerians can do it. I'm glad that in Morocco now, they have the largest solar plant in the world. It can be done. I'm glad that in my own Kenya, they now have one of the largest wind farms which generates power. It can be done. I'm glad that during the president of Akufo-Addo, Ghanaians have now abandoned one of the words they used to have in their vocabulary called doomso. I'm glad. In other words, if you look very keenly, there are things that can be done. And I'm suggesting to us that in order to do these things, we must ask ourselves how it can be achieved. As I draw to the conclusion of my intervention, I now want to talk of the new threats. How can we make it? A lot of writing has been done in the recent past about Africa. There are certain things that Africa must do, and there are certain things that Africa must not do. The belief that we can borrow money from multilateral institutions and become rich is misguided. Zambia's Dambisa Moyo, in a book, Dead Aid, tells us it cannot be done. That is the route not to take. The belief that we will follow a model that is conceived on our behalf by European universities is misguided. I want you to read the book written by a Korean called Ha Jun Chang, The Bad Samaritans.